by Karl, starting on the 10th in the second round. Seems okay with that. He went left on this hole yesterday, so he was trying to avoid going left at all costs. If you miss right, you've still got a shot at the green. So Karl's found the bunker off, the right-hand bunker off the tee on the par 5 tank. They're playing into the wind today, wind coming off the right, so that must have been a pretty big miss hit. Now, what people aren't aware of is that the players don't get to warm up with anything other than irons at this course. So this course, they go up to the first or tenth tee, whichever they're starting on, and they haven't yet hit their woods. So that results in all the players being less than accurate off the tee and adds to the pace of play. That was a good shot out there by Carly, picked that up real clean. Right, Carl's had a good shot out of the bunker. It was quite a deep bunker too, as you'll see from where his, how far down his head was. Just guessing, I'd say he's probably got 130. This will more than likely be a 9-iron in his hand because the wind's coming off the right and hurting. He's got to avoid going left on the breeze. Seems happy with this. That's a good shot, good commercial shot that. 20 feet right of the flag, it's come back a bit, but two putts to open up with a par would be a good result. And now Carl's using his counterbalanced putter today because his ghost putter misbehaved yesterday, had 32 putts with it for a 7-over opening round. So when the putter misbehaves, it gets put back in the trunk. This putt's on its way. Oh, good putt. Right in the jaws. But after his putting performance yesterday, that's just gold. It was just a roll short there. So the reason we didn't film the first round is the winds were gusting up to 50 kilometres an hour in Carl's round yesterday, which equates to about 35 miles an hour. So it was just any videoing that I would have done just would have been nothing but wind noise, even though I've got a proper microphone. The best score yesterday that, I mean, these are the best amateur golfers in Australia, not just boys but men. The best score that anybody could do yesterday was even 73. That's how tough it was. It's par 4, 11th hole. Yesterday Carl used hybrid into a very strong left to right breeze and ended up taking bogey. So today I said to him, mate, if you're going to get in trouble closer with the hole. And that is the rough on the right actually thins out the further up you get. So he's just pulling out driver today. We'll try and play a baby cut starting up the left side of this dog leg left to right. Likes it. And people say, oh, should play safe. But the fact is, sometimes if you can hit it a long way, the driver will get you past a lot of trouble. That's a good solid start by Karl on the opening hole. That's Karl's drive. He's driven at 300, has 100 left of the flag. This will be a smooth sandwich. He doesn't want to put a lot of spin on it, otherwise it might rip back. going to take a couple of steps and then stop. Okay, stop. Here it comes. That's going to be a very slippery right to left putt. But nevertheless, it's a good shot. Putting for birdie. Right, Karl's only got to breathe on this putt and it'll break right to left, an absolute ton. It could easily end up 6 to 10 feet away left down the hill. This is a putt he's just got to nurse into the hole. This putt's about touch. Must come in from the top side. That ball go. It just keeps on going. So he lipped out and it's now 6 feet away. So Karl needs to get his speed with this putter under control. He had 32 putts yesterday, including a few 3 putts. And he needed to have been nursing that first putt there for birdie a lot more than he did. This is for par now. You don't want to be leaving yourself 5-6 feet for par. It's getting par the hard way. He's from tee to green. He played pretty good yesterday, but he just wasn't converting any opportunities. The 12th hole. Wind's coming off the right. Karl needs to play a cut shape down the left side here. He took bogey on this hole yesterday. He's got the bunker. We'll see. No, he's perfect. Long way up. Now it's into the breeze. That's probably only gone about 280 yards. The reason Karl was looking a little bit worried was because his ball's finished just short of these bunkers there. But he was teeing off into the breeze, so his drive's only gone around 280 and didn't get to the bunkers. But he was worried a bit there for a second. He's got 170 yards left to a front pin. He needs to think seriously about throwing this all the way up to the flag. There is a slope from the front of the green up to the flag. 170, this will more than likely be a 6-iron. He likes this. It's a good shot. Now the difference between today and yesterday is today Karl had the opportunity of going to a nearby driving range and warming up with his woods. Yesterday, because he was off at 8 o'clock and the local driving range didn't open until 7, he didn't have the opportunity of hitting woods at all before he played yesterday. Karl's pretty much got the perfect angle here. He's straight back up the green to the cup. So we've got around 12 to 13 feet. His pace today is much better. His ghost was misbehaving, so he's gone back to his spider slant, counterbalanced. Right. Carl's made much better fist of holes 10 through 12 today than he did yesterday. Yesterday he bogeyed all three, today he's parred all three. come frightfully close to birdies on a couple of them. So 13th hole, 444 metres, add 44 to that and that gives you the yard, so it's 484 yards. Par 5, wind assisting. Karl should be expecting to get there easily in 2. Yeah, so just going back to why we didn't film yesterday's round, the conditions were diabolical. It was blowing up to 50 kilometres an hour, which is 35 miles an hour, and the club selection alone was just treacherous. But, add to that, Karl's putter went on holidays, so he had a 7-over par round. But even with his 7-over, he was still middle of the pack. Nobody, and these are most of Australia's top-ranked amateurs, nobody broke par yesterday. That's how tough it was. Wind assist. 488 yards, wind assisting. If Karl hits the fairway with his drive, he's only going to have a mid-iron into the green. He birdied this hole yesterday in horrific conditions. Pointless me panning out to try and see where the ball lands, because this is going to carry around 290. Hopefully it's on the fairway, but I get the feeling it may be just in the right edge. Will Sekar's caught the right fairway bunker. It's actually going to play up the adjacent fairway. Playing partners have signalled that his ball's good. That's a good out there by Karl. Karl's only left with about 70 yards to the flag. Wind assisting, so you wouldn't expect this ball to check much. It might bite a bit on about the third bounce. Feet. Right, the fourth straight hole. Karl is putting for birdie. About 15 feet. Good speed. Oh, shave the edge again. Shaving the cut all round. That was a hard putt to read, that one. I had a look down the line of that putt and I couldn't pick it. So if you're not sure of how it's going to break, just hit it straight at the hole. Karl to tidy up for his par. So it's all square after four holes. It's a good start. Short par 4 coming up here, that measures 360 yards downhill. Never going to get there, so it'll be interesting to see what he uses off the tee here. He has the wind assisting, so there's not going to be much draw or cut, whichever club he uses. He's using 4-iron. 4-iron will leave him roughly 120, 130 yards into the hole. Interesting club choice. I would have thought he'd pull out the big dog. For a second there, I thought Karl was going to use 4-iron, which would have left him about 130 yards. Much prefer seeing this idea. Use driver, just leave yourself with a little flip 60 of about 50 yards. open swing. That will clear the left hand bunkers. So as planned, I'll drove that well in excess of 300, probably 310. He's just got 40 or 50 yards to the flag. He's just going to run this up. The plan here is to use a club with a bit less loft and actually feed it up to the hole. You can actually land it short of the green. You can see, just land it on the fringe there and just let it feed up. Anyway, Karl's the one hitting the ball. Oh, he did what exactly what he shouldn't do. He had the ball forward in his stance. That ball must be back in the stance. Well, Karl played that shot exactly the way he shouldn't play it. He had the ball forward in his stance on very loose grass. You can see the grass here is just sort of dead, dry stuff. You can't have the ball forward because the club goes straight underneath the ball. The ground just gives way. He should have had that ball back in his stance. You live and learn. That's why, well, it's originally why actually we video these rounds, so we can look back at shots like that and make sure he doesn't do it again. Anyway, you can get up and down for par. I like this. Karl's gone to the bag and he's pulled his putter out. I like this idea. Just keep the ball under the flag, a couple of feet under the flag. You don't want to go past this flag. No, I don't like this idea though. Unless he's going to use a pitching wedge, but he's got a lofted wedge in his hand here. I don't like this idea. Oh, he's hold it. Told you I didn't like that idea. So that takes Karl. Yeah, he's a freak show. Just an atrocious second shot after an absolute bomb off the tee. He still manages to walk off with birdie. Well done. One over through four or five.
Alright guys, so that's my first tournament back in Australia. Racked up. I missed the cut by a shot. Unfortunately, so I wasn't able to make it to the next part and then match play, so obviously I was trying to make the cut, but I missed it by just one shot, and you know you can always save a shot somewhere, so I was able to take up a couple things from the tournament and practice that stuff, but we were only able to film the qualifier and the second round here at this tournament, because the first round was 40 plus mile an hour winds, so very, very strong, and even though my dad has a very good microphone on his camera, it would have been very hard to hear, and you wouldn't even probably be able to hear my dad talking, even though he's like this far from the camera. So we just didn't want to film that and show it. But I shot 7 over, which was 80, and second round I came back and shot 5 over, which was 78, and my best round was actually in the qualifier, and I shot 77. But there's always room for improvement, so I took out stuff I needed to work on and ran out and grinded on that at the driving range that I practice at, which is just like off mats. It's like a public range, but I've been there for a while now, but hopefully getting membership sorted out soon. So hope you guys enjoyed the video, and hopefully you guys can be patient to see me play some better golf in the next upcoming videos.